I live in Arizona. Arizona is the fentanyl superhighway. There's no cleaning that up. There's no cleaning up the fact that you welcomed these people in and you welcomed the crime, you welcomed the terror, you welcomed the weapons of mass destruction, and now you want to recognize there's a problem. As far as I'm concerned, Alejandro Mayorkas is a traitor and he needs to be tried for treason. He not only needs to lose his job, he needs to be hung in a court in front of the entire country to see.
Well, that escalated fast. So that's Newsmax. Of course, you have not necessarily of course, but that's Rob Schmidt, the guy that looks to be both made out of plastic and miming plastic during that segment. And that's Josephine Dunn, who admittedly has experienced something very difficult to imagine having to go through. She lost a child. Her daughter died as a result of an overdose, apparently on some sort of Percocet that had been adulterated or something like that. It's unbearable. I can't imagine going through that. I have a daughter, so I hate that she went through that. That doesn't necessarily mean that you get to just choose whichever government officials you've been told by right-wing media are bad and then say that they should be publicly executed. I don't think that that's fair. And I do think that if you're gonna bring on a person who is advocating for things like that, you have to push back at least a little bit. So just to make sure that you know that he didn't, here is how he responded to her calling for him to be publicly executed on live TV.
He has harmed, there's so much blood on his hand. He has harmed so many people in this nation. Yeah. So many people, so many families like mine have been destroyed.
And then they lie to your faces. When you question them, they lie and say, we're doing everything that we can. For 3 years, they told you they were doing everything that they can as people died, as chaos ensued in this country. And then right before an election, as I said, you're right, they can't clean it up, but they can try and they're trying right now. And they're showing us that it was all intentional and they could have changed it at any point and they didn't.
Okay, two quick points there. One, is that guy like on a permanent tilt? What is going on there? Is the building like falling apart as they're doing the show?
Hey, I'm glad you're here. Listen, in order for the Damage Report to keep on going, we need viewers like you to become a member on YouTube. Can you click the join button on YouTube today? Thank you.
More importantly though, you might think, since you don't have the full context, what he's talking about at the end there is they had an opportunity to fix this, but then they prove that they're not going to, that it's all for show. You might think he means they had this incredibly hardcore right-wing border bill that they could have passed and chose not to. No, he's not talking about that. He's fine with that. Neither him nor the grieving mother of someone who died to fentanyl seem to care about the fact that the Democrats gave the GOP a GOP border bill to lock down the border. And the GOP was like, no, we don't care. They're literally gonna turn around and say that the Democrats are playing politics when the GOP transparently took marching orders from Trump, who said, I don't want you to pass this bill before the election because it'll hurt me. So keep letting the fentanyl in, keep letting the adulterated drugs in. I don't care how many people die. I need to win this election. And they're both perfectly fine with that, which seems weird to me. Yaz, what do you make of it?
Yeah, what was she even talking about? She was just throwing out all kinds of buzzwords that don't really make sense whenever they're strung together. They don't even string together into an existing right-wing talking point, like the Mexicans are terrorists, I guess, and there are weapons of mass destruction in Arizona. Are we invading Arizona? I don't know. And no one is denying that fentanyl is a problem in this country. And it's completely tragic what happened to her and her family and so many other people and families across this country. But as he pointed out, this isn't about lives being lost. This isn't about protecting people. This is about politics. And we know that both parties do this. Both parties are guilty of this. They will drag out issues. Whenever he was talking about how, you know, they could have done something about this, but then they didn't. The first thing that I thought about was Roe v. Wade and how, you know, we could have done something about it, but we didn't because they wanted to keep it as an election topic, right? They wanted it to, it's something that people are going to vote based on, you know, and it's really sad because in the meantime, people are suffering and these people are just like playing some game like it's The Sims.
100%. I love that that's the game that you chose to reference that, like a game like Fall Guys. I love that. Anyway. Thanks for watching our video. Did you know that you can support our show by becoming a subscriber? Just click the subscribe button and also ring the bell so that you get notifications when we're live or when we post new content.